Last time, we learned that there are three openings that leave the body: the urethra, the vagina, and the anus. Were you able to find them all? If not, don't worry. Today, we'll take a closer look at where they are and what they look like from the outside. The only part of the menstrual anatomy that we can see from the outside is the opening to the vagina, which is this bigger opening here in the middle. In front of it is the urethra, and in front of the urethra is a bump called the clitoris. These are surrounded by two pairs of labia, or lips. The outer pair of labia is fleshy and gets covered in hair when you reach puberty. The inner pair is thinner and doesn't have any hair. They close together to protect the vagina and help keep it clean. All of this together is called the vulva and is between your legs. So if we take a look at the three openings we learned about last time, the urethra and the vagina are enclosed in the labia, and the anus is back behind the vulva. By the way, how many of you felt uncomfortable looking at the vulva? Actually, that's a pretty common response. Most of us have been taught to think that pictures like this are inappropriate. But these are normal, natural, and beautiful parts of your body. There is absolutely nothing inappropriate about them. If you've ever been curious and looked at your vulva, you probably noticed that it doesn't look just like this picture. Maybe it's a different color. Maybe the labia are a different size. Maybe your clitoris is a different size. Maybe there's more or less hair. Whatever the difference, that's okay. The size, shape, and color of everyone's vulva, labia, and clitoris are different. There's no one right way for it to look. That's just part of what makes us all unique. And if you haven't taken a look yet, go ahead and have a look using a hand mirror. It might feel funny at first, but it's a great first step towards getting to know your body better. Now let's have a quick review of all the parts we've learned so far. Uterus, fallopian tube, ovary, vagina, clitoris, labia, and vulva. Great job! You're now an expert on menstrual anatomy and one step closer to understanding your body.